Here is a Global News update.
Good afternoon, I'm Mike Anscombe. The Young Offenders Court in Orangeville became the scene of a legal wrangle today over the rights of a juvenile accused of murdering two children Sunday before last. Defense lawyers want the court closed to the public and the media to protect the identity of the accused, who by law cannot be named. First-degree murder charges were laid on Sunday, a week after an 11-year-old boy and his 9-year-old sister were found asphyxiated behind a local school. Global's Paul Dalby will have a complete report tonight on the 6 o'clock edition. The number of women entering the job market with university degrees and going after higher-paying positions is being offset by the higher number of women taking on low-paying traditional work, such as waitressing. And we'll have more on that story on First News at 5:30. U.S. President Ronald Reagan has ordered his cabinet to slash government spending drastically after being presented with shocking new budget deficit projections. Budget Director David Stockman estimates the U.S. deficit will exceed $190 billion if nothing is done. But in Ottawa, Finance Minister Michael Wilson says the U.S. deficit will not affect economic forecasts for Canada that he made last week. Details on the World Report. The space shuttle's Canadian-made robot arm played a major role in retrieving the second satellite in the Discovery's multi-million dollar salvage operation. After harpooning the wayward satellite, astronaut Dale Gardner slowed it down and, using his jetpack, maneuvered it toward Joe Allen, waiting at the ship's cargo bay. Anchored to the Canada arm, Allen took the Westar 6 and then handed it down to Gardner in the bay for stowing. Mission accomplished. And that's News Update. I'm Mike Anscombe. Have a very nice afternoon.